Chapter 30. Then Moses spoke to the heads of the Israelite tribes and said, "This is the Lord's command. When a man makes a vow to the Lord or swears an oath, and so puts himself under a binding obligation, he must not break his word. Every word he has spoken, he must make good. When a woman still young and living in her father's house makes a vow to the Lord to put herself under a binding obligation, if a father hears of it and keeps silence, then any such vow or obligation shall be valid. But if her father disallows it when he hears of it, none of her vows or obligations shall be valid. The Lord will absolve her, because her father has disallowed it. If the woman is married when she is under a vow or a binding obligation rashly uttered, then if her husband hears of it and keeps silence when he hears, her vow or obligation by which she has bound herself shall be valid. If, however, her husband disallows it when he hears of it and repudiates the vow which she has taken upon herself of a rash utterance with which she has bound herself, then the Lord will absolve her. Every vow by which a widow or a divorced woman has bound herself shall be valid. But if it is in her husband's house that a woman makes a vow or puts herself under a binding obligation by an oath, and her husband, hearing of it, keeps silence and does not disallow it, then every vow and obligation under which she has put herself shall be valid. But if her husband clearly repudiates them when he hears of them, then nothing that she has uttered, whether vow or obligation, shall be valid. Her husband has repudiated them, and the Lord will absolve her. The husband can confirm or repudiate any vow or oath by which a woman binds herself to mortification. If he maintains silence day after day, he thereby confirms every vow or obligation under which she has put herself. He confirms them because he kept silence at the time when he heard them. If he repudiates them some time after he has heard them, he shall be responsible for her default. Such are the decrees which the Lord gave to Moses concerning a husband and his wife and a father and his daughter, still young and living in her father's house.